George Air Force Base from a distance. Karen, you want to give me that?
Thank you. items that I was telling you about that came in from the city or the state of Utah.
Yeah.
Okay, this is all direct current transmission lines. And this is where the San Fernando Valley gets all of its power.
Godzilla's playtoys.
That's the power plant converter that they had to build a road to.
What's that?
Pretty innovative, because right here on this property is what we call the RTC facility.
The RTC facility?
Yeah. It's going to go on that lot. Over here in the corner over here is going to be a firehouse. That along a fire department. I have a fire station here. And the RTC facility is a return to custody facility under contract with County of San Bernardino. And the city's going to operate this as a kind of a halfway house for convicts getting out of prison before they get back into civilian life. Quite a bit of money in operating. They're going to have their own employees, and it's taken something like 10 years to put this thing together. The the other kind of built-in device I think the city had in mind of doing that is to block the thinking of putting prison facilities at George Air Force Base on the basis of, gee, if you got one, why do you need two? So they kind of nipped it in the bud, if you will.
Dig in.
I'm a little late on that.
Go ahead.
This is Industrial Park, Phase 2, right up here. There's 65 acres over there.
Okay, now, if you could stand over there, I'm going to try and get you in the back lot there. Yeah, that's about right. And not quite. Why don't you stand a little bit? Yeah, that's all right. Okay. Time you're ready.
Okay, this is the intersection of Rancho and Raccoon Streets in the industrial park development of Adelanto. This is considered to be phase two. From this point, westerly represents 165 acres of planned industrial development. All of the property is sold out by the city. plants under construction at this time, several of which are now completed. There's estimated to be something like 3,000 employees that will ultimately end up reporting for work here in this phase two of this industrial development. The 5-acre parcels represented in phase two, sold by the city for $75,000, that represents about 34 cents a square foot. You can see the desirability of that type of land ownership by industry. When you take a look at this corner piece right here, that represents 20 acres of land that has the same facilities, same utilities, I should say, water, sewer, power, streets, access, but it's privately owned, not a part of phase two. Price on this parcel here is $66,000 per acre.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay.
20 acres, that's about $1,300,000 for this.
Don't tell her about animals, Dad. She'll want one.
Coyote?
Anything. Thank you.
outfit that brings the products up here. We're going to manufacture up here as well. It's a distribution for utilities everywhere up here in Idaho. And Koala is paved only as the western line of phase two. But it's front burner priority by the city administration to pave this all the way down to Palmdale Road. And it'll go through phase three. And it'll also be paved northbound up to El Mirage. So in doing so, this is going to open up the entire western side of the city, clear down into the assessment district. And it's a very significant part of the development of the city. And this is priority here. Pavement for Koala stops right there, as you see. And it's going to be paved all the way down to Palmdale Road. And it will go right through Phase 3 Industrial Park. Phase 3 is directly on the other side of those cross-country power lines. And I'll take you down there and show you that area. This is phase two. Phase three is going to be right there on the other side of those lines. And this road's going to go through that park.
It's gonna be hooking up with phase three, right?
Right. Yeah, I'm just taking a kind of good idea of what. Sold this parcel of land right here. At least we tried to. And a Chinese physician, a fellow by the name of Yong Suk Kim. I understand Kim is as common as Smith is as a name.
You sure he wasn't a Korean?
I think he was Korean, yeah. Pardon me, you're right. Korean, good. Yeah.
Yeah.
And he has a daughter by the name of Chris, and she's his interpreter because he doesn't speak English very well. She's a neat little gal. I really enjoy her coming up. And they come up here about twice a week. And he put an offer on this property in here. And this 20 acres of land right here, which is be private land right next to the Industrial Park 3. And the parcel was offered for sale for $900,000. And he offered $700,000. The seller said, no, he countered. He said, I want my price. He went to $800,000. He said, no, I want $900,000. He went to $900,000. The seller says, well, I've decided not to sell unless I get $1 million for it. I'll take it off the market. And that's what you're up against here. That 20 acres stopped at 900. It's almost got into a bidding situation, but it's unfortunately the conditions that we're getting involved with up here. It's that volatile, you might say.
That?
I see, that's Commercial Wood Products, which is a furniture manufacturing company. They're supposedly having something like 300 people come up here to be employed in that plant there. This area is north and south is all manufacturing industrial.
Where are you going to take us to now?
Well, we're going to go up into by City Hall, up into some of the residential areas.
Can always
come it out.
Yeah, well, try something else. Go ahead and turn it off for a minute. Oops, why I lost my white balance. Shoot. Okay, go ahead, turn the light off. I'm gonna bring my balance in. Okay, go ahead and shine it down like this. Let's try that. Regardless of
it's a little hot.
Do you want, can you raise it?
Yeah.
You can stand on the chair.
No, that's okay. I'll just paint it out.
Either that or I can do this.
No, that changes the color temperature.
Color temperature.
Yeah. Bring it back up. Yeah, it's much bluer. I'll just cut it out and paint it.
What out? You got some shadows?
No, yeah, I'll paint the shadows out.
Okay.
Sure. Free focus here again. I'm still rolling. Try checking this balance too.
You just need one good still.
I know, but I want to make sure I'm focused too.
Well, I think
these are
all
what I'm going to do is I'm going to swing around this way. Thank you. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, you see REC up in the upper right?
Okay.
You ready?
Go.
Right here, right?
Yeah.
How's that?
I told you not to go beyond that.
Let's try it
but
again.
But it looks all right anyway.
Let's try it again.
Okay, one more time. It looks clean.
Let's
okay,
get some more dirt.
Here we go.
We need more dirt.
More dirt. Set the props.
Just playing around.
Okay, okay, okay,
okay.
Okay,
so
good, good.
That look normal?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Ready?
Okay, ready, go. Perfect.
How's my thumb?
Your thumb's fine. Yeah. Go. Okay, good.
Okay.
Charge people with motorbikes and all-terrain vehicles, green sticker vehicles, I guess. Basically, get in there.
So this is again. This is what again?
It's going to be the Bureau of Land Management recreational park for all-terrain vehicles. And they'll charge admission, and they're going to keep it in the wild, so to speak. They're not going to bring water in or any development. People bring in what they have to have and then bring it out. ATVs are caught in the desert area outside of the perimeter of this park. They'll be sighted. The idea is, I guess, is to, if you're gonna tear up the desert, you're gonna do it in one confined space as opposed to all over Southern California. Multi-million dollar project.
What's the date? 3rd? 1-3-90 at Sanford Wood. And we're painting the bottom.
You ever want a bad case of copper poisoning? Put this in your coffee. Delicious and nutritious. Smooth as a baby's ass. Get them little buggies out of there. Candid camera, right?
You got it.
Just like mom's cooking. $170 a gallon, it better taste good. The scaffolding here, take it away. You can't pull it on this side. We're actually going to be using it again, but if you need it, you can borrow it for a while.
Well, no, I'm taking this down over here. I want to, you know, if you guys want me to leave it on this side of the boat.
Someday we'll look at this video and all laugh like shit, right?
Break? Oh, yeah, break. They put garbage shit on it. This is fine. I got to eat it. I have to go get it all together. Next for a video.
Saturday 4-7. We're still in the boat. This is a new tape. This tape is obviously out of sequence. So if you're in edit room and tearing your hair out, grin and bear it for just this tape and the next three tapes. Also, post slate on another tape. Test tape also has some stuff from today, which I mistakenly put on. So carry on.
The two aft ones should be American, the two forward should be
Taiwanese.
And 3/8 is fits it fine.
Yep. Okay, well 3/8 may have fit the 11 millimeters, but it didn't fit these others, so. I'm afraid I'm gonna lose something up inside.
Well, if you drive those up, you might be able to get your socket working, you follow me?
Yeah.
Drive the nut up as far as you can, or just here, take your hatchet and drive it up there.
What are we doing?
Well, the darn screws are too long, and I use deep sockets to get them out, apparently. And
well, you had two nuts on that one, didn't you? Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm turned over.
And with a short socket, you can't tighten it up.
What are we putting in?
And that's the davits, the new davits. You know, it's like everything. Building the davits are easy, just bolting them down is takes forever.
You wanted a hammer?
No, we got a hammer. We don't need that. We got too many.
Oh, what I can't figure out is why that won't.
If you're on the forward ones, you're on the doggone Taiwanese nuts, and they're not acting up. That 11 millimeter is not probably turning because it's Chinese too.
I got the 11s. I got
it's
the 11 fine.
And it's turning now.
The 11 came off just fine. It's these others, these damn Americans, won't work right.
Oh, no. No,
the 3/8. Okay, I have a 7/16. What's between 7/16 and 3/8?
3/8 will fit. You can try them. They're right there. The 3/8 fits.
Got it right here, too. what's in there. I don't
You're know. Recording this for posterity?
That's criminal.
Posterity, maybe. We're not prostrate.
Okay. Posterity.
The forward appears to be weird.
That's the Taiwanese. The weird ones are in the forward one.
And as we ran into that goddamn there on that anchor winch, too. I couldn't get a socket to fit. I bet they bought them from the Japanese.
That's a problem. They bought them from the Japanese.
Whoa.
Case out of it. All right, I'm on it. Give it some horsepower.
3750
yards, 121,
19 left.
Was he talking?
What if they say press status?
You got the wiring done?
Almost.
Can you get any of them out?
Core, we could wrap these guys.
Okay.
Actually, are you busy doing something else, or do you want me to do that?
No, I was just.
Yeah, let's do these in threes.
These in threes.
Yeah.
The tonic water.
So you're wrapping two or three of those together?
Yes.
So three. They won't roll around.
Yeah. Do you want them like this, Richard?
Yeah.
Head up.
You need a hand for this?
No.
Oh, that's pretty neat. You got that wrapped around there. Cool.
a defunct Loran.
Is that what it is?
Yep. It doesn't work. Right? It's not working.
Why not?
It's not picking up the signals correctly. Too many people ripping plastic.
Is that why it's not working?
No.
You don't know why?
Something wrong with it.
I know mine works there and his doesn't, so I'm thinking it's probably on the ranch. Now, I need one washer, I think. Oh, there it is.
Any luck yet?
Yeah, we got them. What I need, happened to the... Hey, Dick, I need another nut.
So they're going in?
They're going in just fine. We had to cut them down because we didn't have a deep socket wrench to fit over them. Did you tell those guys I need another nut?
Yeah, I'll tell them.
Tell them I need all the nuts.
Okay.
Unless they want to keep one for cutting.
Hey guys, they need some nuts down here.
Yeah, we got three of them right there.
Are they over here?
Yeah, just. Well, Dick, you know there was two of those new ones. Now there's one, and there was three more of these are missing. Where the hell did they go? Everything complicates.
Yeah, they're looking for him.
Oh.
They got him. I'll go look for him.
Quarter 20. You're right, please.
We're going to have two garbage going on board, one for over the side garbage.
Okay, these are chow mein noodles. This is what we're going to be eating for the next 6 months, and but they're really quite good. I think we'll enjoy them.
Are we going to cook them?
Let's see. Cooking suggestions: just add 1 cup of oil, 1 cup of cider vinegar, teaspoon of chunking soy sauce. Yeah, throw them in the microwave. 5 minutes, they're done.
One size fits all.
One size fits all. Our black label ham.
Start again.
We also have here our Hormel black label ham. And just have a look down here. This is our.
Get this.
Some of our supplies going in here. We've got. Let me get down there in the shot. Okay, down in here. You still rolling?
Yeah.
Okay, down in here we have.
Up there and hold.
Down here in this locker we have crab meat, we've got shrimp, water chestnuts, soup, cream of mushroom, cream of chicken, we got VA juice, orange juice. What else? We got more chunking noodles, green beans, and